There's one more thing that I wanted to show you today. And I think this one, you know, a lot of people have been waiting for that. So another direction that in Environment for Revit we're very much committed to is the interoperability. We are not going to replace ACC. This is not what I mean when I say interoperability, but when I say interoperability, I mean in your design and modeling process, being able to transfer information from one software to another. That's a really big issue for a lot of people. So now we have a new panel, interoperability, please explore that. And here is the long awaited Rhino Assets tool, which allows you to take any Rhino 3D model and transfer it into Revit without having to have a Rhino software activated on your computer. So let's take a glimpse and see how it works. I'm going to click on the Rhino Assets tool over here. And of course, the first click that I'm going to do is add Rhino file. Let's browse to find my example. And of course, you can place it in shared coordinates or project internal. You can select the level, you can select the units, click on OK, and it's been transferred into your computer. There it is in my Revit file. How easy was that, right? So the purpose of this tool is to really make it easy, intuitive, and in a few clicks. By the way, it's bringing everything into Revit as a direct shape in the generic model category. However, we wanted it to behave a little bit like a link. So pay attention to this menu over here that allows you to reload, remove, ungroup. Everything is grouped into a Revit group at the beginning, but it really allows you to play with it as if it was a link. Now, the nice thing is you can open this drop-down window and you can directly see all of your Rhino content within your Revit software. And it's organized the same way as it is in Rhino. So you have the layers. If I open it, you can have the type of object. Sometimes we have names. So if you have a name in Rhino, you'll see it over here. You can hide some of the elements that you don't want to see and bring them back again. Again, so easy, so nice. And then let's take a look at some of the features of what you can do with it. So we have layer, object, name, and then import to Revit as. Everything starts as a generic model. Let's open the topography, select it over here. You can see you can turn around in the preview. And let's take the topography generic model and click on the three dots over here, import to Revit as. So I want this topography to be imported as a toposolid in this case, right? So I have to say this is not true for all categories, but for some categories, we do allow you to use system families. So I can actually click here, apply system family. And here in the toposolid type, I can see all the types of toposolids that I have in my file. So this would be an actual toposolid. Again, in just a few clicks, let's click on OK right now and take a look at the results. Let me see here. You can see that everything is a group. Let me ungroup it for a second and take a look at this toposolid. For the question that somebody had before, this is a regular toposolid. So now you can do whatever you can do with the toposolid, you can do with that. But wait, there's a little bit more things that you could do with this feature. So let's go back to the Rhino Assets tool. Open the dropdown here and take a look at some of the things that you could do with loadable families. So for example, the trees over here. You can see that we have two types of trees. An environment can recognize the different blocks that you have. So I'm going to use, maybe take this tree over here, and I want to replace it with an existing Revit family. Let's say the poplar tree. And I can duplicate the family type. So if you want to create a new type that you would know that it came from Rhino, I'm going to duplicate that. Click on OK. Go back to my file. And this is a regular Revit family posted on my toposolid. Don't forget that all of this, if something changes in your Rhino file, you can reload it and environment will remember your previous choices. But let's see another amazing thing that you can easily do with the Rhino Assets tool over here. So let's take the other kind of trees that we have here. And let's say that I want to take the exact same geometry, 3D geometry from Revit, from Rhino, and turn it into a Revit family. That's possible as well. So I'm just going to click here. Select the replace with Revit family. And now instead of selecting family from the drop-down list, I'm going to create a new family here. So environment can take this geometry and immediately create a new family for me. Let's call it Rhino Tree. The category will be planting, of course, in this case. And I can even take the material from Rhino. So if you like the material in Rhino, you can preserve it over here. Or you could just select the material from Revit's material library. In the background, a family is being created. You can already see it over here, Rhino Tree. Click on OK again, and take a look at that. Now I have a Revit family that was immediately created from Rhino. I think that it's pretty amazing. And let me go ahead to the type editing of this family. Environment was able to recognize the height, the original height that it had in Rhino. And I can even change it now. So let's say 10 meters. Oh no, that's too big. Let's go back to 4. That's tiny and nice, like a mushroom. Last but not least, you can see that we have line-based or 2D blocks over here. We worked really hard to make sure that using the Rhino Assets tool, you can also import lines and line-based blocks, because we just know that it's a common practice with landscape architects and we wanted to accommodate that. So let's go back to the Rhino Assets tool over here and you can see the blocks. Let me show you these ones. These are just 2D bench blocks that were placed in Rhino. I can take them and do the same thing, just replace with Revit family and find my bench over here. Click on OK. And the nice thing is not only that they were placed, but their orientation, their rotation is done correctly. So all I have to do now, that's a regular Revit family and host it on a regular Revit TopoSolid. So intuitive, so easy. I cannot stress how much I waited for this tool. It's really amazing. Last but not least, some people like to design their topographies using lines in Rhino. Well, don't worry, we didn't forget you. You can always go to the topography tools. And although you can't use the add line tool, but you can definitely use the from edge tool to simply build a Revit TopoSolid from these lines. Let's change the type of the TopoSolid. Click on finish. And I mean, I think that's a lot, but this is it for the features that I wanted to show today. I really hope you enjoyed your time. Are there any more questions in the chat?
So Mark just asked, does the Rhino file have to remain to keep the created elements or can the connection be broken?
So that's a really good question, Mark. Thank you for asking that. No, you don't have to have the Rhino file. It is imported, so I can delete it from my computer. I don't even have to have Rhino, although I love Rhino myself, and I have Rhino on my computer, and I use it sometimes. But you don't even have to have it. You don't have to have the file. So yeah, it's going to be over there.
So also,
if something in the Rhino file changed, you would have to have it on your computer to reload it. But the elements are going to remain over here.
So Davide is also asking if Rhino is updated with moved bench. So let's say I'm assuming what he means is that we move the bench now in Rhino. Are the benches will change the position in Revit if you reload the file?
Yes, but I will not show you because I didn't prepare for it. So I don't have a Rhino file with the moved benches. But yes, that's the intention. Thank you for asking that.